Are you working with a lot of different file types and want to convert them automatically so you don't have to manually download them, change them, and then upload them somewhere again? Or if you want to forward them, then look no further. This video will explain you exactly how you can automatically transform your file formats into something else that you desire based on three different use cases that we are going to look at. So stay tuned. Hey, my name is Manuel from Techflow AI and we love automation. If you want to get more tutorials like this, like this video and subscribe to our channel. We're outputting a lot more tutorials and a lot more use cases to get you inspired with automation, so stay tuned. Now let's look into our first use case. We have an Excel sheet over here that we want to transform into a regular Google Sheet so we can actually use it further for other kind of automations, and we want to keep it in our Google Drive system. So first let's look at how this looks like. So it's a very simple Excel file. You can see it by the .xlsx at the top, and then it just has some really made up numbers here. So now our goal is to transform this into the actual Google Sheets format, and then we can use that to automate it further. We can add rows, we can remove rows, and we can do other fun stuff with it. So how do we do this? In Make, this is a pretty simple scenario. We are using only Google Drive modules for this one. The first one is we simply watch files in that specific folder. If you don't find it or if you're testing it, remember right click on it and choose where to start, and then you can choose from now on, since specific date, all, or choose manually, which loads a list of files in that folder, and then you can select the file that you actually want to work with. So if you run a watch module, it will like consume that item that it watched, and you have to choose where to start again if you're testing it. Otherwise it will just be empty and there will be no more files, or you simply have to upload a new file every single time you test it, which is insane. So that's a small hack. Choose where to start and you will be able to test it over and over again. The next thing that we're going to do is we are going to filter that our file extension is actually xlsx, because we only want to modify the files that are xlsx and not the ones that are already Google Sheets. We don't need to process them. Then we simply download them. So we have to download them into Make in order to upload them again in a different format. It's a little bit of a brain twister, but I think you understand the concept here. And then we are uploading it again to the same folder. And then we are doing one specific addition here, and that is turning on the show advanced settings. And then we can choose the target Google file type when we turn on the converted file. So we convert a file, yes. And then we can select that we actually want to have a spreadsheet. So the XLSX file will then be transformed into the Google spreadsheet format. All right, let's run it once and see what it outputs. So the filter passes because we have the XLSX file with the actual file extension XLSX here at the very top. And then that's why it passed the filter. We download the file and then we upload it again to our Google Drive. So let's check it. We now have the Google Sheet over here. You can see it by this symbol, and this is the Excel file. And now if I open that one, it actually shows no more the XLSX tag here. It still has it in the file name because we did not remove it. We could theoretically remove it as well, just to avoid any kind of confusion. You can do this by going here, and then instead of just using the file name, you can map it, and then with the file name, you can simply say like replace and then the XLSX.XLSX with an empty string. So it gets removed like this. And now we could run it again. Remember, choose where to start. I just say choose manually. No, I can say all actually. So we can test it. And now it output two results because there are two files in it, but this file does not have the file extension. So it's not an XLSX file because it's already that previously transformed Excel file. And then only the other one gets uploaded or downloaded and uploaded again. And now we should have another one which does not contain the extension XLSX anymore in the name. So now it's clear that this one is not an XLSX file anymore. All right, that's our first case. Now let's jump into the second one. The second one is actually pretty fun. So you could design a full email newsletter within Google Docs and then send that exact design via email, via the Gmail module, for example, to your customer or to whoever you want. So you can create templates within Google Docs and then convert them to HTML, and then you can send them off to via Gmail. How do we do this? So this is just a sample template that we want to send out. And then going into our scenario, we watch the file again in a specific folder where this Google document is. Then we check if it's a Google document file, because only then we want to download it and process it. Then we download the document. You can specify the type to HTML.html, and then you simply put in the full data of the downloaded document in HTML with content type HTML and any two email address. You can even say, okay, I have like variables in my document, or I create a new template from a doc, or like I can say, okay, I have variables that are named specifically. For example, it could be, I don't know, first name like this. And then you say any map variable that we could put here, so that way you could modify the data, the HTML data, by inserting this one in your actual template here. So it could be like this, and then it will actually replace this one and make it dynamic. So let's try this out. If I run this, it downloads the document, it sends the email, and how the email looks like, let's check it over here. So here we have our email newsletter. It has company, blah, blah, blah. The full design is here. It looks nicely, and it also has this dynamic parameter, hey manual, in here. And you can do this for bulk sending emails to customers, or like sending out nicely formatted newsletters, or simply having like a small template that you want to use. So that's nice. And that's it for this use case. Then the third use case we're going to look at is converting images. So let's say we have an image over here, the Predator wallpaper JPG, and we want to transform that into a PNG file. So whatever image file we have, we always want to have a PNG file in the end, and we can use an automation for this. So this is how it looks like. We are watching the files again in this folder. Then we can have a condition here, or multiple conditions, to check if it's an actual image file. So file extension, for example, like this. There are also other options. So you could theoretically also, for the MIME type, which is this one, and then only get out image. So where it starts with image. Let me add that in. So MIME type, and then the text operator starts with, and let's make it case insensitive, and then image. That could probably replace all of the previous ones, and then you don't have to set up the multiple filters. And then we want to download the file, and then we are using a service called Cloud Convert, and that is really powerful. You have 25 conversions per day, which are free, so I highly suggest subscribing to Cloud Convert, just trying it out, because it saves a ton of time. And it allows you to upload a file and then transform it into something else. So you can be really quick in transforming any file format to anything else. So here, for example, we can say, I don't know the input format, so it will work with any image file. And then the output format should always be PNG. And we need to choose a file name, including our extension. So here we are replacing the file extension from the name, so the name does not contain the file extension anymore. And then we are adding .png at the end, because that's our target output format. And we also want to download the file back into our scenario here, into Make, and then upload it into our Google Drive. And now let's run this and see what it does. The conversion takes a couple of seconds, so don't worry about it. The bigger a file, the longer it takes. And here we go, our third use case. Now we have a .png file here. It's the same file, just transformed into a different format. And now you can use wherever you need it, the .png file. So just for clarification, or just for notice, there are a lot of different file formats that you can use. So let me show you here. Like, there are a ton of different file formats that you can transform to anything else, if it's a CSV file or a DMG, whatever. So just scroll through the list of files, like HTML, you can also transform them. That's also a powerful one, HTML to PDF. That's what you're using oftentimes. So if you're getting an email and you want to transform it into a PDF. For example, a receipt is just being sent as an email. You can transform it into a PDF and then upload it somewhere else. So if you don't want it to be changed anymore. Then like all kind of different, even video files, MP4 and so on, you can transform all of them. So look at it and really check it out. It's a powerful tool. I can only highly recommend it. And then you can also check the output format based on what you select for the input. It will offer you possible output values for this input format. And then like for image, it will only show possible image formats that you can transform it into. So yeah. And then like there are more tools available, for example, merging files, which is also great if you want, if you have multiple documents, multiple PDFs and want to merge them into one file, you can also use Cloud Convert for this. And then also a lot of other things, but these are the main two things I like about Cloud Convert. So I highly recommend checking it out. It has 25 free conversions per day. All right, if you learned something new today, please leave a like below this video and subscribe to our channel. We are coming up with a lot more videos and use cases. And also, if you have any questions about this, put them in the comments below the video and we're going to get back to you very soon. And if you have any specific thing, any topic in mind that you need clarification on with make.com or any automation related topic, then also feel free to share it with us and we're happy to shift our gears and record a video about your request. Thank you very much for watching and see you in the next video.